and one explosive issue in the budget centers on a relatively small amount of money, whether to restore $7.5 million in funding for family planning. Adrian Cipino has that story.
Much of what family planning does has to do with women's health, mammograms.
Stop. Family planning has nothing to do with mammograms.
You don't think there are family planning centers that provide mammograms, pap smears, women's health issues?
Listen, family planning has nothing to do with mammograms, and don't put the two of them together. They don't have anything to do with each other.
Are there family planning centers that provide women's health services, such as mammograms, pap smears, and other women's health issues?
Pap smears, yes. Mammograms have nothing to do with this, and there are other avenues available to people to get that care.
It was these words that triggered the firestorm in Trenton today. Democratic lawmakers pushed bills in both houses attempting to put the $7.8 million back in the budget. Supporters addressed what they suspected was the sticking point for opponents.
It cannot and will not fund abortion services.
They claimed family planning is vital to the health of New Jersey families and expressed disappointment about the governor's comments last night.
I'm assuming that the governor does know a little bit about women who can't afford private physicians, don't have private insurance. I'm assuming he knows a little bit about the fact that HIV screening, cervical cancer screening, family planning issues are health issues.
The bill cleared the Senate Budget Committee. Republicans abstained or voted no. Democrats voted yes.
All three of us got our health care, at least when I was in college, from family planning service. Montclair, I went to Montclair State. That's where I got my health care. That's where I had my pap smear. That's where I had all of my primary health care. I didn't have insurance. And I worry about the young women that are in the same position that I was many years ago and having nowhere to go. Well,
it's estimated that Planned Parenthood and other family planning centers like this one serve 140,000 people in New Jersey. Without the money, New Jersey would become one of a handful of states in the nation that don't have family planning as part of the state budget.
Sometimes people forget that I don't just deal with the reproductive organs. I deal with patients who come in with all sorts of issues, mental health issues like postpartum depression, women who come in with cancer.
But it was in the assembly that the issue truly got heated.
If you want to have sex and think you might get drunk or high, plan ahead by bringing condoms and lube or putting them close to where you usually have sex. This is why people don't support Planned Parenthood.
He suggested the group was trying to stop poor women from having babies.
What really starts to offend me about this debate is the suggestion that there is a cost savings to the state from preventing children being born.
And because you found a brochure put out by a international Planned Parenthood that has nothing to do with New Jersey, you are going to tell me and tell the women of New Jersey that you're going to vote against funding for women's health care. I find that personally offensive as you found that brochure.
The Assembly Budget Committee approved the bill along party lines. Most Planned Parenthood centers do not provide mammograms, as the governor suggested. Democrats say they found an alternative source for the funding. Both houses are expected to vote on the legislation on Monday. Adrian Cipino, NJN News, the State House.